Hello friends, welcome to Learner's Planet. Friends, this is our fifth session for algebraic identities. In the previous session, we discussed problems based on cube of algebraic expressions, and we discussed good number of problems. In this session, we'll be taking more problems based on algebraic identities. So let's begin the session. Let's discuss this problem. Here x4 plus 1 upon x4 is given, and we have to find out x cube minus 1 upon x cube. Now we discuss x square plus 1 upon x square whole square, right? What that will be? X4 plus 1 upon x4 plus 2, right? Now x4 plus 1 upon x4 is what? 119, and this is plus 2, so it's 121. Now x square plus 1 upon x square will be square root of 121. Now square root of 121 will be plus and minus 11, but we cannot take minus 11 since x square and 1 upon x square, both of them are positive terms, so the answer will not be negative, so it is 11, right? Now this is what the first value that we are getting. Now what we do x minus 1 upon x whole square. Now that's x square plus 1 upon x square minus 2, right? Now x square plus 1 upon x square is what? 11. So it's 11 minus 2, that is 9, right? So x minus 1 upon x is equal, whole square is equal to 9. So we'll be taking x minus 1 upon x as 3, right? Now we got the value of x square plus 1 upon x square and x minus 1 upon x. Now what? We have to find out the value of x cube minus 1 upon x cube. Let's see what happens. So x cube minus 1 upon x cube can be written as x minus 1 upon x into x square plus 1 upon x square plus 1. Now we can put the value of x minus 1 upon x, that's 3. X square plus 1 upon x square is what? We can see that's 11, and this is plus 1. So it's 12 into 3, 36. Okay. I hope you are clear. Now, in this case, we have to evaluate this. Now, using algebraic identities, it will be really very easy to evaluate this sort of expression. Now 103 can be written as 100 plus 3. So this is what? A plus B whole cube. Now what A plus B whole cube is? A cube plus B cube plus 3 A into B and A plus B. Right? So it's what? 100 cube is 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Then this is 27. Then this is 900. So that's 92700. Now we have to add up all of them. So just write it 92700 and 27. 7272910. So this is the answer. That's 103 whole cube, right? Now let's try this problem. Now 598 can be written as 600 minus 2, and this is whole cube. Now a minus b whole cube is what? A cube minus b cube minus 3ab, right? 3ab and a minus b, right? Now 6 cube is what? 216, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, minus 8, minus 6, 2s are 12 into 3, 3600 into 598, okay? So this calculation is 215280, right? So the final solution will be 213847192, right? Now let's try this sort of problem. This is a cube minus b cube format, and what's a cube minus b cube? That's a minus b a square plus ab plus b square, right? So 111 cube minus 89 cube will be what? 111 minus 89. This is 111 square plus 111 into 89 plus 89 square. Or it looks tedious. What alternatively you can do is 111 can be written as 100 plus 11. So it's 100 plus 11 cube and this is 100 minus 11 cube, right? So rather than this, we can go for this method because this will be really simpler. Now this is a plus b whole cube. So it's a cube plus b cube plus 3 a into b a plus b, right? Minus this is a cube minus b cube minus 3 a into b a minus b, right? So now what we can do, just expand the bracket. 100 cube plus 11 cube plus 3300 into 100. So 3300 into 100 plus 3300 into 11 minus 100 cube minus and minus plus 11 cube and then minus and minus plus 11 into 3300 into 100, right? Then this minus minus plus and further minus, so it's 11 into 3, 3300 into 11, right? Now 100 cube is cancelled. Then this is 3300 into 11 and this is 3300 into 11, that is also cancelled. So now we have 2 times 11 cube plus 330000, right? So 2 times 11 cube is 1331 plus 330000, right? So we have to make this calculation now. So that is 662662. Okay. I hope you are getting it. Similarly, this is 40 plus 6 whole cube and this is 40 minus 6 whole cube. So this is a cube plus b cube plus 3 a into b a plus b, then plus here a cube minus b cube minus 3 a into b a minus b, right? Then 40 cube plus 6 cube plus 4 threes are 12 into 6, 72. So it is 720 into 40 plus 6, 3 fours are 12 into 6, 720 into 6 minus 40 cube, I'm sorry, plus 40 cube minus 6 cube minus further 720 into 40 plus 720 into 6. Okay, so 6 cube is cancelled. Then 720 into 40, that's also cancelled. So we are left with 2 times 40 cube plus 720 into 6. Okay, so that's 2 times 64000 plus 0 this, right? Now just simply add and multiply. So that's 136640, right? Now friends, we have done good number of problems. I just explain you one more problem that we have already discussed. If x plus 1 upon x is 3, then we have to calculate the these given expressions, right? So x plus 1 upon x whole square is equal to 9. So x square plus 1 upon x square plus 2 is equal to 9. So x square plus 1 upon x square will be 7, right? Now if you square this, x square plus 1 upon x square whole square will be 49. Then x4 plus 1 upon x4 plus 2 is equal to 49. So x4 plus 1 upon x4 is equal to 49 minus 2, that's 47, right? So we got the value of x square plus 1 upon x square, x plus 1 upon x we already have. So x cube plus 1 upon x cube is what? It's x plus 1 upon x, x square plus 1 upon x square minus 1. So simply put the value of x plus 1 upon x and x square plus 1 upon x square, and you can get the value of x cube plus 1 upon x cube. So x plus 1 upon x is 3, x square plus 1 upon x square is 7 minus 1, so it's 6, 18. Okay, so the problems are very easy. If it is given, you can calculate this. If any one of them is given, you can calculate this, right? So just you need a bit practice. Yeah. Now in this question, we are given x4 plus 1 upon x4 and we have to find out all these, right? So what we do, x square plus 1 upon x square whole square is equal to x4 plus 1 upon x4 plus 2, right? Now x4 plus 1 upon x4 is given to us as 194. So it's 194 plus 2, so that's 196. That means x square plus 1 upon x square will be square root of 196, that is 14. We'll be taking the positive values because both the terms will be positive, right? So x square plus 1 upon x square is 14. Now x plus, I just mark it as 1, x plus 1 upon x whole square will be x square plus 1 upon x square plus 2, right? Now x square plus 1 upon x square is 14, so it's 14 plus 2, 16, right? So x plus 1 upon x is equal to square root of 16, that's 4. Now we got x plus 1 upon x, x square plus 1 upon x square, so we can get the value of all these three. X square plus 1 upon x square and x plus 1 upon x we already got. Now x cube plus 1 upon x cube will be what? Use the formula aq plus bq, that is a plus b, a square plus b square minus ab, right? So x plus 1 upon x is 4, x square plus 1 upon x square is 14 and minus 1, 13, so it's 52, right? Just do some 4-5 sums on this pattern and you'll be getting good grip on the same, right? Now friends, further we have some different pattern of question. Here we have to find out the products. Now in this case you need some practice, so you can make a comparison between this and an established algebraic identity, right? Here suppose, just listen to me carefully, it is a plus b, it's a square minus ab plus b square, right? Just look at it carefully. A square, that is 3x whole square 9x square, and 2y square 4y square, 2y whole square is 4y square, and minus ab is 3x into 2y, right? So this is actually this pattern, and this is what? A cube plus b cube, right? So this answer of this we already know. So here what we can do, we can directly use A as 3x and B as 2y, but you need to represent this step in your exam, right? So A cube is what? 3x whole cube plus B cube is what? 2y whole cube. So it's what? 27x cube plus 8y cube, right? So if you are able to identify the algebraic identity, the problem will be very simple for you, or the product will be very simple for you, right? Just two step as you can see over here, right? Similarly, over here, it's a minus b, it's a square plus ab plus b square, and this is equal to a cube minus b cube, right? Just verify this. A square, that means 4x whole square is 16 square, 5y whole square is 25y square, plus 4x into 5y, that's ab, right? So directly put the value of a and b over here. So that's 4x whole cube minus 5y whole cube, that's 64x cube minus 125y cube, right? So the sum can be solved in seconds. Now further we make a comparison. Friends, here there are two terms, here there are three terms. So bright chances are that it will be a cube plus b cube or a cube minus b cube format, right? So this is a, this is b, this is a square, 49p8, yeah, a square, this is b square, yeah, and this is minus ab, that is 7p4 into q, right? So now it is very simple. It's what? A q plus b q. A is what? 7p4, it's cube, plus b4, b cube is q cube, right? So 7 cube is what? 343, and this is p raised to 12 plus q cube. Just two steps, right? Similarly, it's a minus b. This is what? A square? Yeah. This is b square? Yes. This is a into b. So it's, yeah, it's a into b. So this expression is nothing but a cube minus b cube. Straightforward, put the value of a and b. So that is 3 by x whole cube minus 5 by y whole cube. So that is 27 by x cube minus 125 by y cube, right? So similarly, you can do more problems. Just make the comparison like this. And while making comparison, do not make the calculation errors. Similarly, in this case, two terms, three terms. So it's a minus b. This is a square. Yes. This is b square, and this is plus ab, right? So this is what? A cube minus b cube, okay? So x square whole cube minus 1, that is x raised to 6 minus 1, okay? Just one step. Now in this sort of questions, if we need to put up the value, then how would we solve? Further, just listen to me carefully. This is a, this is b. Now see, this is a square. Yeah, it's 9y squared square. So a square plus 9 into 4, 36, x square, y square. So yes, it's ab. And then plus 4x squared square, that's b square, right? So this is what? A cube minus b cube, right? So a cube is what? 9y square whole cube minus b cube is what? 4x square whole cube, right? So it's 9 cube, that is 729 into y raised to 6 minus 64x raised to 6. Now put the value of x and y from here. So it's 729, y raised to 6 is what? Minus 1 raised to 6, that's 1 only, minus 64, x raised to 6 will be what? 3 raised to 6, right? So it is 729 minus 64 into 729. So precisely 729 can be taken as common. So it will be 1 minus 64. So it's minus of 63, right? So it is 4, 5, 9, 2, 7, and that to negative, right? So the steps are really same. So after reaching here, you have to put up the values of variables, right? So there is no difference at all. Now in this case, a plus b and ab is given, and we have to find out the value of this. So what is a cube plus b cube? That is a plus b, a square minus ab plus b square, right? Or instead, what you can do is you can find out a plus b whole square. So that's a square plus b square plus 2ab, right? So a plus b whole square is what? 100 is equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab is what? 16. So it's 2 into 16, 32, right? So a square plus b square is what? 68, right? Now we want this. That's a square minus ab plus b square. So a square plus b square is 68 minus ab is what? 16. Right? Similarly, we can find out a square plus ab plus b square. So that is 68 plus 16. Okay? Isn't it very easy? Our friends, in the next session, we'll be taking one or two more pattern on algebraic identities. We have done so many sums, and if you do all these sums once again, you will be really gaining the confidence in algebraic identities, right? So once you should watch the session, in the second time, what you do, you just try the questions on your own, then match your answer and solution with mine, right? So this way, you'll be able to learn the concepts and you'll be gaining the confidence, okay? Bye-bye.